Hey Dan here, and if you're an ENFP, I don't know why you're watching this video because us ENFPs, we've never procrastinated in our lives. We're the kind of people that when we want to get something done, whether it's cleaning up, accounting, boring homework, that's what we do. We just get it done and go about our days in a very organized fashion. So again, not sure why you're watching this, but just in case you're one of the three or four ENFPs in the world who occasionally struggle with procrastination, I thought I'd make a video for you. Reach out to the three of you. So step one to defeating procrastination is assume that your brain consciously and unconsciously is intelligent and logical. What I mean by that is whatever you're actually doing with your body, whether that's avoiding stuff you're supposed to do, you know, procrastinating, whatever it is, assume there's a reason behind it and there's a logical reason, like your unconscious mind is making a choice. And one of the good ways to look at this is pain versus pleasure. And just assume that we're motivated by one of these two things, either pleasure, we feel like by doing something, we'll get a positive emotional reward, or pain, we feel that by not doing something, we will avoid pain, right? In the case of procrastination. So generally, if you're avoiding something, if you're procrastinating, it's because your unconscious mind, among other things, there's other things I'm going to get into here, but among those, it's because your unconscious mind is associating more pain with doing this thing than with not doing it. And often this is the case. I mean, if we want to think back, like, well, in my case, thinking back to say university, is I would procrastinate studying or finishing a paper until the last night. And that's just how I worked. And I spent probably a week up until it worrying, wondering why I was procrastinating, maybe feeling bad about that. But ultimately, it was probably the smart choice because I tend to do my best work under pressure with tight deadlines. I mean, this is something I learned about myself sort of afterwards, but I do my best work when the clock is ticking and there's very limited time available. So probably, maybe on some unconscious level, I was doing that calculation. Like, listen, the exam's on Friday, it's Wednesday. If I don't go to this party, that's gonna be a lot of pain. If I do go to this party, there's gonna be a lot of pleasure. And probably I'll pull it out of my ass and get a B on the exam anyhow just by cramming on Thursday. And that's ultimately what ends up happening. So that can often be the case, I think, where us ENFPs, we beat ourselves up for procrastinating. And I'm going a little off script here, off topic, I should say, but we'll often beat ourselves up for procrastinating when really we should just accept that we do things last minute and just do it last minute. Use that burst of adrenaline, get it done. And in the week leading up to that, instead of feeling like, oh, I'm procrastinating, I feel so bad, be like, I'm going to the beach and then I'm going to do the thing the night before. That's one option. That's one way to do it. Another way is change this pain-pleasure relationship by making things more enjoyable. For a while here in Prague, I had a personal trainer. I had some, nothing serious, but a bit of back pain from being a tall guy who works on laptops all the time, as you might expect. And these workouts we did were intense. And ultimately I did feel good after them, but I felt like I dreaded them pretty quickly, right? And so it did become a situation where when I was thinking about going to work out, there was some dread because I'm like, I'm not going to enjoy this. Like I might feel good after, it might be what I need, but I'm dreading the experience, right? That's okay sometimes, right? I could still get myself to the gym to go to these, but it was taking a lot of willpower to get there, right? What if I had made it fun? Like maybe I found a topless hot yoga class somewhere here in Prague, or, you know, went and played volleyball with my friends or went for a run with a buddy, right? Something that would make it really fun and enjoyable, then I wouldn't need all these strategies to, you know, trick myself into doing it because the actual thing would have more pleasure than pain and therefore I would just do it, right? So think about that. If there's things that you find tough, you know, something I've been doing with like admin work, things I need to get through is I have sort of the two monitors set up and on one of the monitors I'll throw on like a mediocre kind of documentary thing, like something by Vice, or I think I've been watching like Ross Kemp Extreme Worlds, like where he goes to some crazy places. And it's something I don't really need to pay much attention to, but it makes it a little more fun, mix in a glass of wine, 7 at night, have some wine, have the TV on, and then go through and do that boring admin stuff. It at least makes it a little more enjoyable, so you don't end up procrastinating nearly as much. As well as one of the things I've started to do is try to associate more pleasure with just finishing these kind of tasks, right? So if I have to finish an hour of admin stuff, I'll try to focus on how good it will feel when I get that done and hold on to that feeling, and that will help bring me through it as well. And there's three more things on top of this pain-pleasure relationship that I think you can do to reduce or eliminate procrastination. One of them is use forced environment. So I work for myself, as you may or may not have gathered at this point, and I work from a variety of places. I have a home office, I have a co-working space I go to, I have another sort of office space co-working setup, and then there's a bunch of different cafes I work from. And I find different environments work really well for me for different types of work. That could be because I now associate them with that, or it could just be something else, I don't know. But if I want to get writing done and sort of more creative work, I go to a busy cafe. If I want to get like work that I might tend to procrastinate, go through my emails and clear out the ones I don't need to respond to and that sort of thing, or do some kind of accounting work or whatever that is, I find that going to a co-working space works really well for me because it puts me in this sort of professional environment and it's just like, get this work done and then you can go home. And that works really well. So maybe with your procrastination, whatever it is you're procrastinating, see if there's something you can do, like take your work to the library, to a cafe, to a bar, like whatever is in your neighborhood, and just get it done. And that might actually also help with the pain pleasure side, because if you go somewhere that's a little more lively, a little more fun, it will make it more enjoyable and you'll get it done that way as well. But I find that really helps. If I go somewhere with one thing to do, like I bring the paperwork with me to a cafe or a co-working space, I say, I'm not leaving until this is done, that can work really well. But that leads me to my next point, which is if you have a ton of work you tend to procrastinate, like you're saying, Dan, that's cool, but I have like 3 hours of work every day that I procrastinate, then change the shit you're doing with your life. If you want to procrastinate 3 hours a day of the stuff you do, you need to find new work that you enjoy doing more. Because ultimately, all these little tricks, all the Ritalin in the world is not going to, well, actually, all the Ritalin in the world probably would solve the problem, but it's not the right way to do it. So, on the big picture side, it might not be today, it might not be tomorrow, but over the next 6 months, work to align what you're doing with who you are and what you enjoy. If you're always procrastinating your work, you're doing the wrong thing and you need to make a serious change. And hopefully, I can help you do that here on this channel. If not, I'm sure there's other resources. But that's the biggest thing. If you don't enjoy what you're doing at all, you're going to procrastinate it. It's that simple pain pleasure equation, right? Lastly, if you do find that you procrastinate things that maybe you actually do enjoy, like it doesn't even really make sense, there may be something going on with your brain chemistry. And so things like exercising more frequently, eating healthier, less carbs. I'm on a crazy eating regime right now. I eat like 50 grams of carbs or less a day, but even reducing it to like 200 grams of carbs a day or something like that, it makes a huge difference. Eating better, vitamins, exercise, all this stuff, it can have a really positive impact on your brain chemistry. And another thing that I found works really well, it's not really tied in with like diet and exercise, but for some reason this made me think of it, is doing something I really enjoy at the beginning of the day tends to like tweak my brain chemistry. Like I'm happy and feeling more productive throughout the rest of the day. So I end up getting a lot more work that I might otherwise procrastinate done later on by starting the day doing things I really enjoy. So I hope you found at least a couple things there that will help you with your procrastination. Try them out. If you want to commit below in the comments to what you're going to try out or some changes you might make to make something a little more pleasurable, a little less painful, share those in the comments below. And if you haven't yet, for God's sake, click that subscribe button. Join me here in the channel and our community, and let's create a kick-ass life together. Thanks for watching. Talk to you soon.